Hello and welcome to today's session on GS answer writing. See, in today's session basically we'll be talking about how to write an answer in your GS, in your OPSC. See, basically what happens is that most of us have prepared for the UPSC, and as we know, UPSC always asks to write your answer in points. Well, that is one of the most preferred way of writing the answers. But again, there is a big difference between OPSC and UPSC. See, in both the contexts, you can write answer in points. But what's the problem with the OPSC? See, if you're going for the points, remember that the points should be more than 5. If it is more than 6, so far so good. More than 7, again it's the best. No. But if you are writing in paragraph, then what happens is that the examiner might not be able to judge you on the basis of points. Rather, he would judge you on the basis of knowledge that you have shown. So basically what happens is that some say that the paragraph is the most preferred way of writing, given the condition that the examiner will not be counting the number of points. Hence, your marks that examiner would award you will not be limited to the points that you have written. Simply, odiyare bujhantu je jette ta apana points lekchanti hoy to points hisabre apanku marks de dabo ki examiner, but paragraph wise ra kon hala na points hisabre marks na milke para kete lekchan sei hisabre milyo. So if you are going for the points, I would say go for more than 5 points always. And if you are going for the para, so far so good. But there is no theory that you cannot go for points. There is nowhere in that. Even we got marks by writing in the points, and we are quite sure of it. Next. See, when you are writing basically an answer, there is always a thing is that okay, how basically can we enrich our answer? Answer enrichment. See, basically answer enrichment can be done, number one, by adding flowcharts two, by adding diagram, let's say your India map or your map of forest. Now in what case can we add flowcharts? See, basically if I let's go for a question. Recently Divya Ranjan had posted in the group itself that what were the reasons for the decline of the Indian handicraft industry during the British period. Now in this context, let me make point. See, what are the reasons for handicraft industry? First, I would say is that basically the taxation policy of the Britishers. Next, I would say is that decline of the patronage that they got from the ruler after the Battle of Plassey. I hope you remember the Battle of Plassey, 1757. Next, what else can be again I would say that ban on usage of Indian made textiles. Basically those were dyed. Now see, in such questions I made 3 quick points. Do it and then move on. But again, let's move on to your diagram session. Now first of all, in this context I'd be teaching you how to draw the India diagram and how to draw the diagram, the outline map of Odisha, the outline map of India and Odisha. With respect to India, see, basically I would divide this into a proper lining. Now this is the India map. Simply, first of all, just draw two lines in the cross section and then keep joining the lines. That is simply how you draw a India map. Next, let's come to the map of Odisha. Now this is how you can draw the map of Odisha. I hope you got that. Now how is this map beneficial? See, supposing let's ask where are the forest resources of the map. Now forest resources in Odisha, you can just show where are the forest resources. We have the tropical deciduous type, we have the tropical moist type, we have the over here, what do we have? We have over here this littoral forest. Now in this way you can show. Similarly, in India case also you can show that we have a tropical, such a large area has been covered by tropical deciduous. Again, we have the tropical evergreen, we have the tropical monsoonal type of the forest over here. But this is the basic necessity. Now some says that being the subject diagrams are necessary only for geography. No, it's not that context. Diagrams are also necessary in your GS. With diagrams you can enrich your marks. At least the examiner would be happy to see that this guy is doing something. The guy at least know how to draw the map of Odisha. Now this is something that attracts the examiner. Next. See, when we are writing the answer, one thing remember that. This is one and the most important point in OPCS. Hit to the point. How do we do this? Any question, just simply state what this question is asking. Let us resolve a question. Let's see that what was the role of the intellectuals in the social reform movements? Role of intellectual in the social reform movements. Now I have seen that in such question, people basically do is that the social means they make a starting like this. The social reformers were the light of the movement. They were the modern people who were very well educated. They were educated in this, they were educated in that, and hence they brought this, they brought that. That's bullshit. Don't do that. Simple, the role of the intellectuals in the social reform movement are as follows. First, how did they propagate the education? By opening of the educational institution. Secondly, you move on to how they stood against the social evils. How they supported the press. Fourth, modern movements such as the preaching monotheism. Hit to the point. Don't go round and round. Do not go round and round. Hit to the point. Moving round and round will do nothing but you'll lose your number one, you'll lose your time, and you'll lose your marks. How difficult is it to say that the role of the intellectual in the social reform movement with this is or not? Isn't it easy? But why do we make it complicated? Remember that in answer writing, please do not make answers complicated. Make it as simple as possible. It is the simplicity that will give you the marks, not the complexity. Never put in mind that writing high sounding words, writing with this, that and all will give me big marks. No, that's bullshit. Please do not write that. I hope with this you basically understood what is that. Try and make your answer simple. That is number one. Simple answer. Number two, add flowcharts wherever possible. And if not flowcharts, diagram. Next, again, write in paragraph, write in point, doesn't matter. If you're going for the points, go for more than 6 points. at least I would say go for more than 6 points. And when you're going for more than 6 points, it should have an intro and it should have a conclusion. What is the intro? Whatever the question has been asked. Whatever the question has been asked, put that question as your intro. No need to give a very damn brief intro. You won't have such times. 300 marks that we see, we are basically facing 300 marks. UPSC, you face a 250 marks. Remember that. In this case, we have the more number of questions. We have a huge number of questions that needs to be addressed properly and specifically. And we have to give at least that every question has to be given a proper balance. It's not that, yeah, I am very good in geography, I'll give geography very good balance and then I will compromise with the history and I'll compromise with the politics. Don't do that. You'll be losing severe marks. There's no need of, basically, there's no need of doing such a thing. Balance each and every question properly. That's the main motto of this. Balance each and every question within this 3 hours. Balance. Balance each and every question. This is the simple strategy. Now, one of the things is that some people say that, sir, I first started with this, statistics in the paper 2, you have the statistics, and then I went for other. See, if you're good at statistics, go for statistics, no issues. But sometimes also one of the thing that we face is that sometimes they say that again OPSC is very orthodox. Now if you're going serially, they give you marks proper. If you're going in a haphazard manner, that might not be suitable for the examiner. So basically we tried to analyze this thing, and what we found is that, see, basically when the examiner is checking, obviously he would be irritated. So many papers would be given to him for checking. Now in this context, if you have done it systematically, so they would also arrange the paper systematically. If you have done it non-systematically, so again the paper would be arranged in a non-systematic manner. So in this context, what happens is that there might be a chance where the examiner would get fed up that this person has not written the answer systematically. But again, it's very difficult to ascertain that. If I say that in the paper two, if you say that, no, I'm very good at statistics, I'll go for statistics first, go for it, no issues with that. But still then, remember the things that we have said. At least keep in mind, if you think, I would say that be prepared to go from the first to last. That's the safest way. No need to take a risk over here. From the first to last, be prepared and go that way. I hope you got a clarity over what to write in a GS answer. This is nothing but a simple technique. There is nothing more than that. And please make your answer simple. No need to complicate it. There is, even I would say this again for the essay. Simple answer, get the best marks. Complicated answer, lose marks, lose time. Thank you.